divided into multiple cells and then finite control and we have an additional stack. So this stack is bidirectional. So these are the three components. So here this pushdown automata is similar to finite automata in terms of input tape. Input tape is common in both the cases. Along with that, finite control is also similar in finite automata and pushdown automata. The only extra thing is stack. Okay, we added stack to this PDA in order to provide extra storage space. So what is this input tape? How can we define this? So the tape is divided into multiple number of cells where each cell is used to store one input symbol. So say suppose I have input string like this, AABB. So the symbols in this, they can be stored like this, AABB. One symbol can be stored in one cell. And we have finite control with a pointer. Okay, this header is used to read one symbol at a time. So here the symbols will be read from left to right, one symbol at a time. And we have an external stack which is with a two bidirectional arrow. So this bidirectionality is used in order to perform, because it performs push and pop operation. So insertion and deletion will be done. So we are using this. And then here, after reading this input string, the string may be either accepted by the machine or it may be rejected by the machine. So both the conditions may be possible. So this is a complete model. Fine. So we already saw stack. So stack means two things are, first is it follows LIFO and lasting first out principle, and the operations used are push and pop. And the stack provides infinite storage space. Okay, so as the stack is infinite, you can store more amount of data or information in this stack. So this is the complete model of pushdown automata. Let us see the definition of PDA in terms of tuples. So PDA can be defined as, so PDA is a collection of 7 tuples. Okay, so while reading one concept, try to remember the previous concepts also, so that you'll get more clarity. Okay, regarding, you'll find out the difference between one concept and the next one. So if we discuss about finite automata, number of tuples used are 5. If it is context-free grammar, number of tuples used are 4. Coming to PDA, here it is 7. Okay. So the first 5 tuples which are used in finite automata are common in pushdown automata also. So what are the 5 tuples used in finite automata? They are Q, Sigma, Delta, Q naught, F. They are seen. Along with this, we have 2 more extra symbols. One is Z naught. Okay, and the other one is Tau. So Q is nothing but, we already know, it is finite set of states. And sigma is input symbols. Delta is your transition function. Q naught is initial state. F is final state. This is F. And Z naught is a stack symbols. Okay. Sorry, Z naught is not stack symbols. Tau is stack symbols. And Z naught means it is the initial or starting symbol in stack. Okay, if this is your stack, then stack symbol should always be Z naught. Okay, which is nothing but this one. So TDA can be defined as seven tuple industry. So this is all about the model of PDA as well as the tuples used in the